All right, guys, welcome back to another Skin Health Reversal video. And today I want to address the topic of smoking marijuana with psoriasis. Should you do it? Is it going to throw off your healing progress? And can it be included as a part of a healthy lifestyle? Now, let me just start by saying that smoking weed, I believe to be one of the more generally least abrasive kind of drugs that you can do. You know, for instance, it's not going to have the same kind of impact on your health as something like alcohol would. But of course, everybody's different. But generally speaking, from my experience with myself and working with people, smoking a little bit of weed versus drinking a little bit of alcohol, you're better off smoking the weed in terms of the impact that it's going to have on your skin health. But with that said, there are, of course, you know, some negatives that you need to consider here. The first thing is, you know, anytime you're inhaling smoke into your body, it's going to cause some sort of oxidative stress. And if you guys saw my recent video about the root cause of psoriasis, I really think it all boils down to oxidation and oxidative stress, and ultimately just decreasing that response in the body. So if you're someone who's smoking every day, you know, smoking several times throughout the day, or even if, you know, you're just smoking, you know, a couple times, you know, throughout the week or whatever, inhaling smoke is going to cause oxidative stress to some degree. And I do think, you know, if you can find balance with this and, you know, smoke in a moderate fashion, it's gonna be okay with people. But if, you know, every day you're waking up, you're smoking several times throughout the day, you're upping the amount of oxidative stress that your body has to deal with, and it's not going to yield the best results in terms of your skin health. The second negative that you want to consider here is the fact that smoking weed has been proven to lower testosterone, at least temporarily. It's been shown in studies that after you smoke, for the next 2 hours, your testosterone is going to be suppressed. So, and like I said, this, it has proven to be like kind of a temporary sort of thing, but if you're, you know, a quote unquote pothead and you're smoking every day and suppressing that testosterone day after day, several times throughout the day, it's going to throw off your hormones. And if you've been dealing with this for a while, you know, experimenting with diet, you already know that your hormonal health is a key piece in this. And if you're throwing that off every day with smoking weed, it's obviously not going to be great for you. At the end of the day, what we're looking for on this, you know, journey for clear skin, we want to optimize our hormonal function. You know, we don't want to be consuming things that are extremely estrogenic and are going to be, you know, suppressing our testosterone. We want a cool, kind of even ride throughout this. And another thing to consider is, you know, obviously a lot of people who smoke weed, you probably notice that it makes you tired, and, you know, things like the munchies are a real thing. These are obviously negative side effects. One of the main things that you want to pay attention to as you're going through this process of, you know, building your diet and building your psoriasis regimen from the ground up is your energy. I'm always talking about focusing on health indicators. And if you're consuming something on a daily basis and it's depleting you of energy and you're having to take naps all the time because you're smoking weed, that's throwing all sorts of things off inside of your body, your circadian rhythms, like I mentioned before, your hormonal balances. So I think what this all boils down to, as with basically everything else, you know, that I talk about on this channel, if you're gonna smoke weed, you need to find your balance with it. And, you know, a lot of people out there say weed is not, smoking marijuana is not addictive. I completely and utterly disagree with that. I think, you know, it can be very mentally and physically addicting. Obviously, you're not gonna have these physical withdrawal symptoms like, you know, an alcoholic say would, but there are physical withdrawal symptoms that people experience when they stop smoking weed. But in my opinion, I think it's more of a mental thing. You know, a lot of the people who I've grown up with, you know, smoking weed, they smoke a whole lot of weed. It's a very addictive thing. People try to push it off like it's not, but in my opinion, it's very addicting and it's very hard to control that. But if you can find that balance of smoking weed in moderation and using it as, you know, just something to have fun with, kind of like a stress relief thing, you know, over the weekends or whatever, I do think that it can be included in a healthy lifestyle in one way or another. But like I'm saying, there are definitely negatives to consider, and it can be really hard to find that balance. But if you have that kind of sense of being headstrong, and, you know, you're already disciplined with your diet and, you know, sticking with things in that regard, I do think that a lot of people can implement marijuana into their life. It's definitely not the devil. And like I said, it's one of the more least, in my opinion, the least abrasive kind of mind-altering drug. So all in all, you want to consider the fact that inhaling smoke is going to increase oxidative stress. You want to consider the research and the information that tells you that consuming marijuana is going to suppress your testosterone temporarily, and you want to pay attention to the way it impacts your health indicators. I always tell you guys, you know, to eat a certain kind of food and study how your body reacts to it. You know, do the same thing with marijuana. If you're smoking it and it's making you tired and it's throwing off your days and making you less productive, obviously that is not a good thing for your life and for your health at all. So if you can find that balance and use it properly, I do think at the end of the day, marijuana can be included, but as I keep saying, it's hard to find that balance, but people with the right mindset and the right discipline can definitely do it. So I'm gonna cut this one pretty short today. As usual, head to my website, naturalpsoriasishealing.com, if you wanna check out my additional resources. From there, you can watch my Proven Psoriasis Protocol free training video, you can apply for one-on-one coaching, and you could also watch my psoriasis supplementation video that can help some of you guys really dial things in on the supplement end of things. So as I said, all I got for you guys, I'll see you in the next video.